Welcome to a special episode of Power Play, the video podcast that travels the world to explore the hard truths of the energy transition. I'm your host, Paul Browning, and this week we're taking a break from our European adventures. I've been thinking a lot about data center demand, and I've decided to devote some time to figuring out where we're headed in the global race to achieve artificial general intelligence. After doing the work, I decided that this episode can't wait until I return to the U.S., so let's go. According to futurist Ray Kurzweil and entrepreneur Elon Musk, artificial general intelligence, AGI, the point where machines match human cognitive abilities, will likely be technically possible by 2029. But this isn't going to be an episode focused on AI technology. It's about the exponential growth in electrical power that's going to be needed to take the leap to AGI, and why the U.S. is better positioned than any country to meet both the technological requirements and the electrical power requirements that AGI is going to require in this decade. Luckily, we at PowerPlay all became exponential thinkers in Season 1, Episode 8. So what will it take to power this next frontier of human achievement? The answer is staggering, and today we'll break down exactly what kind of power demands we're looking at and how they stack up against the current and future capacity of the U.S. power grid and other players around the world. To understand the scale of the challenge, we first have to understand that most data center capacity today is to support things other than AI. Before AI, data centers were essential for running traditional IT workloads, hosting websites, supporting enterprise applications, managing data storage, providing cloud and connectivity services. Their role was primarily about enabling digital business operations and ensuring data availability, security, and providing computational resources on demand. With the AI boom, data centers have evolved to support far more computationally intensive and specialized workloads, significantly increasing their power and cooling requirements and pushing the boundaries of what modern data centers can handle. The power demand to support those traditional uses of data centers has been growing at a rate of about 8.5% per year since 2020. But data center demand that's specific to AI has been growing faster, much faster. It's been more than doubling each year during that same time frame. So just like we had to segregate wind and solar power growth rates from hydropower growth rates to extrapolate future renewable power supply in Season 1, in this analysis, we're going to separate non-AI data center growth from AI-specific data center demand growth. In 2020, the total U.S. power demand from data centers was about 14.5 gigawatts, with AI-specific demand making up only about 0.3 gigawatts of that total. From 2020 to 2023, we have the actual U.S. data for AI-specific and non-AI-specific data center power demand. We also have a very good estimate for where 2024 will end up, so I've included that in the data set as well. AI-specific demand is growing so fast that it's already almost caught up to non-AI demand by 2023. And by 2026, AI-specific power demand will actually be higher than the non-AI demand. Fast forward to 2029, the year when AGI is projected to arrive, and AI-specific demand alone is expected to skyrocket to approximately 457 gigawatts. That's more than 10 times the power demand of today's entire U.S. data center industry, and it's being driven almost entirely by the insatiable needs of AI training clusters. Adding these up, an extrapolation of the combined total power demand for data centers by 2029 is 488 gigawatts, with AI-specific demand making up the lion's share. Now, let's compare this to the total capacity of the U.S. power grid. As of today, the total generating capacity of the U.S. power grid is about 1,280 gigawatts. So with a data center demand of approximately 488 gigawatts by 2029, we're talking about data centers alone requiring more than a third of today's U.S. power grid capacity. This is a staggering figure and illustrates the sheer scale of the challenge we're facing. It's clear that without significant upgrades and expansions to our power grid, we'll come up way short on the power needed to achieve AGI in the U.S. So why am I claiming that the U.S. is best positioned to lead this charge? Well, a big part of the answer lies in the country's unique combination of energy independence, low-cost electricity, and geopolitical advantages that create hard truths for the rest of the world. First, let's talk about energy independence. The U.S. is the world's largest producer of natural gas, thanks to the fracking boom of the early 2000s that we discussed in Episode 11 of Season 1. Natural gas now fuels nearly 40% of U.S. electricity generation and has helped drive electricity costs down to an average of about 8.3 cents per kilowatt hour, among the lowest in the world. The hard truth for Europe, where energy prices are more than twice as high due to reliance on imported natural gas and some coal, combined with recent geopolitical disruptions in Ukraine, is that their power grid is just too expensive to power AGI. Combine that with Europe's difficult regulatory environment, and it would be very difficult to move fast enough in Europe, even if it was affordable. Second, we have to consider the climate change implications of all this AI power consumption. The U.S. has made significant strides in reducing its power sector carbon intensity. Since 2005, U.S. power sector emissions have fallen by over 40% thanks to a combination of natural gas and renewables displacing coal-fired power generation. And as we continue to retire more coal and deploy more natural gas and renewables in the U.S., we can expect the power grid carbon intensity to continue to fall. This relatively low carbon intensity is a major selling point for companies looking to minimize their environmental impact while scaling their AI operations. But most importantly for the U.S., we have more than enough power projects ready to meet this new demand. In 2023, the backlog of new power generation and energy storage seeking transmission interconnections across the U.S. grew to nearly 2,600 gigawatts of generation and storage capacity, which is now actively seeking grid interconnection, according to new research from the Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory. The queues indicate particularly strong interest in solar, battery storage, and wind energy, which together accounted for over 95% of that interconnect queue. So the U.S. has the projects identified. Now we need a massive accelerant to get them deployed between now and 2029. The Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, FERC, adopted major interconnect reforms in 2023 that have not yet taken effect in most regions. In addition, the Inflation Reduction Act, which was passed in 2022, has put massive new tax credits in place to support deployment of wind, solar, and energy storage. We're going to need a concerted effort from government and the private sector to deploy. So what's the hard truth for China? As we saw in Episode 4 of Season 1, China's moving much faster at scaling up their power sector than the U.S. is. So why aren't I claiming that they'll win the race to AI? Well, another critical factor is going to be access to the advanced chips that are necessary for AGI. AI data centers rely heavily on high-performance GPUs and AI accelerators, and the U.S. has imposed strict export bans on these chips to China, severely limiting China's ability to participate in the AI arms race just as AGI comes into sight. Despite China's impressive capability to build out its power infrastructure, including massive coal and renewable projects, they simply can't access the critical AI chips they need due to these export controls. Add this to the problem that China's power grid carbon intensity is amongst the highest in the world, and this just adds to their hard truths. The United States' unique combination of energy independence, many new power projects poised for implementation, supportive federal policies, low electricity costs, reduced power sector carbon intensity, and unrestricted access to cutting-edge AI chips makes it uniquely positioned to lead the race to AGI. Other regions like Europe face high costs and regulatory constraints, while China, despite its infrastructure capabilities, is cut off from the essential technology. The U.S. stands alone as the only location with the right mix of resources, technology, and geopolitical positioning to meet the immense power demands of AGI. Well, that's a wrap. As we end today's episode, it's clear that powering the journey to AGI by 2029 it's not just about building more data centers, It's about building them in the right place with the right energy mix and the right technologies. The U.S. is leading this charge, not just because of its technological prowess, but because of its unique energy landscape and geopolitical strengths. But it will take a dramatic increase in the speed that we can build new power generation infrastructure to win the race to AGI. The road to AGI is paved with challenges, but for the U.S., it's also paved with opportunity. It's a race that will redefine power, both in terms of electricity and global influence. But the window of opportunity will close soon if we don't seize it. After the November federal elections, whoever controls Congress and the White House needs to put a champion in place to make this happen, or we can wait a few years for China to develop their own version of NVIDIA's chips and take the AGI prize. Thank you for tuning in to this episode of Power Play. As we've seen, the future of AI isn't just about large language models and big data. It's about kilowatts, gigawatts, and terawatts of power. If you found this discussion insightful, make sure to like it and to subscribe for free to the PowerPlay YouTube channel. And please join us next time as we continue traveling the world to explore the hard truths of the energy transition.
Curve, how long does it keep going for?
Yeah.
And I think it's likely enough that it will keep going, that it is worth investing the tens or $100 billion plus in building the infrastructure to assume that if that kind of keeps going, you're going to get some really amazing things that are just going to make amazing products.
Mm.
But I don't think anyone in the industry can really tell you that it will continue scaling at that rate for sure.